So let's start our problem with a quarter circle, and then inside this quarter circle we will inscribe another quarter circle so that one of its vertex is touching the arc of our big quarter circle, the other vertex is touching the center of the big quarter circle, and their radii are aligning on the vertical line on the right, as you can see on the sketch. Now, in this way, we have divided our big quarter circle into three segments, and let's say that the bottom left segment has the area of 2. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of the inscribed quarter circle? This beautiful problem was presented to me by one of my subscribers, Adrian, so big shout out to him. Alright, so you guys can pause the video right now if you want to tackle this problem for yourself and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this problem. So I'm going to start by labeling the center of our big quarter circle as O and the center of our small inscribed quarter circle as Q. Also, I will label the remaining vertices of our big quarter circle and the intersection point between the arc of this quarter circle and our small inner quarter circle is A, B, and C, as you can see on the sketch. Next, let's say that the radius of the small quarter circle has the value of small r, and the radius of big quarter circle has the radius of capital R. Now let's start by rotating the small radius vertically down, and we will get that the line QO also has the length of R. Now let's rotate the radius of our big quarter circle to the point B. In this way we will form this really nice isosceles right triangle BQO. So, since this is an isosceles right triangle, we know that it represents the half of the square, which means that capital R is the diagonal of the square. So it must be equal to the side times square root of 2, in this case, small r times square root of 2. If you can't see this right away, and if you're a newcomer to mathematics, you can always use the Pythagorean theorem on this green triangle and say that hypotenuse OB squared is equal to the leg BQ squared plus the leg QO squared. Then, when you substitute the values from the sketch and work through this, you will get the same result that capital R is small r times square root of 2. And we're going to save this value for later. Now, let's have a look at the small segment in the middle, which I will shade in green. We can notice that this small green segment and our isosceles triangle are both forming our quarter circle BQO. So we can basically get the area of this green segment as the difference between the areas of our quarter circle with the radius of small r and our isosceles right triangle with the legs of r. So let's write this down as an equation. So the area of the segment is equal to pi r squared over 4 for the area of the quarter circle, minus the product of the legs over 2 for our isosceles triangle. We can simplify this a little bit and get the following. And we're not going to simplify this equation any further for now. Alright, so now let's have a look at our triangle BQO once more. Since this is an isosceles right angle triangle, this means that the acute angle of this triangle must be equal to 45 degrees. Now, since the overall angle at the point O is 90 degree angle, this means that the remaining angle, BOA, must be 45 degrees as well. And we're going to use that fact. Let's have a look at our segment with the area of 2. This segment, combined with our previous green segment, both makes this circular sector AOB. So, if we take the area of this circular sector with the central angle of 45 degrees and the radius of capital R, and subtract the area of our green segment, we will get the area of our blue segment. Now, let's write this down as a formula. First, the formula for the circular sector will be the central angle over 360 times the area of full circle, which is pi r squared, minus the area of our green segment will be equal to the area of the blue segment, which equals to 2. Now we can simplify 45 and 360, and we can substitute the value of capital R. Also, we will substitute the value of our segment, which we got earlier. If we do this, we will get the following equation. Now, let's work through this equation. First, we're going to simplify the first term and get rid of the brackets, and we will get the following. Then we will simplify first term once more, and we will get the following equation. Here, you can clearly see that the first and the second term are completely identical, only with different signs. So we can easily cancel them out, and we will get that r squared over 2 is equal to 2. Of course, we can multiply everything with 2 and get that r squared is equal to 4. Now, remember, we are looking for the area of our inner quarter circle, and the area of the quarter circle equals to 1/4 of the area of the full circle pi r squared. Now we're just going to substitute the value of r squared, and we will get the following. After simplifying, we will get that the area of our red quarter circle equals to pi, and this is our beautiful solution. Alright, so I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below. And until next time, see you all and take care.